Gates of Fire. Now, this is a very important book in my life. I've been wanting to do this. This is the reason I got into teaching, I think, is Gates of Fire. Like, God read it and said that it's the greatest fucking book he's ever read, period. Even compared to the Bible. Just like the Bible is a parable on how to live your life and do the right thing, how to be a good Christian, and the Quran is how to be a good Muslim, the Pentateuch and the Torah is how to be a good Jew. Gates of Fire is the Bible for a warrior. How to be, how to live your life, how to be honorable. And it's all about teamwork, which is my religion. Teamwork is what it's all about. It's all about working with your buddy, working with your friends, working with your brothers in arms to achieve things that you could not do alone. And the teamwork that it takes to go rescue people, the teamwork that it takes to go do everything we do. Teamwork is my religion, because I would not be here without the love of my sons and their help. And teamwork. It's all what Pararescue is. Like, because God is in all of us, and you know, working together, the things we could achieve world peace. We could get beyond all this stuff. We could rescue everybody. If we'd only work together. And so, Gates of Fire. It's a more accurate retelling of the story of Thermopylae, or Thermopylae, and it's written by Stephen Pressfield, who is an incredible writer, writes really good books. If you get a chance, the Afghan Campaign, the one about Alexander the Great, it's called The Virtues of War, and these books, they don't glorify war. They glorify mankind and what you can achieve when you set your mind to do something. Leonidas to hold the pass, Alexander the Great to conquer the known world. I mean, he didn't get it all, but he came pretty dang close, you know? It's pretty ambitious for a 30-year-old. I don't know many 30-year-olds that would attempt that. Stephen Pressfield, the man can write. Takes a beautiful story. I also like his Peloponnesian War one. Dang it, can't think of the name of that one right now, but it happens. Anyway, so he gets fire, tells the story of the 300 Spartans and their roughly 6,900 fellow Grecians holding off 2 million. They didn't all fight 2 million, but there were 2 million dudes there, and they took 20,000 with them. So, per guy, he took 3 bad guys with him. If I gotta go, I don't mind that, you know, knowing that I'm buying freedom and some time, you know, like Davy Crockett and Colonel Travis at the Alamo in Jim Bowie. And the other 209 guys. I hate that people have to die for anything, but I guess if you gotta die for a good cause, you know, I'm okay with that. That's how I rationalize it. I don't know what anybody else does, but for me, if I can find a this for that, a proper price for a man's life, then I can reconcile it, but I sure do miss him. And back to Gates of Fire. So many good parts about the book. I mean, and you want to talk to people like, hey, what do you think? One of the big things that I took away from it was the word dais. And a dais, so when they were pairing soldiers to fight at Thermopylae, they would put an old guy with a young guy, a strong guy with a quick guy, a smart guy with a strong guy. You get the, anyway, you'd put people with different weaknesses, and together, if they worked together as a team, as a dais, they were unbeatable. The two brothers were a dais. It's a very good book. I don't even know where to go with it. Like, there's just so much to cover. I couldn't do it justice in 5 hours. You know, I mean, I've been teaching Gates of Fire my entire career as a PJ. I never wanted to make a bunch of rank. I like being with the guys. Never been so happy in my whole life as I am in a helicopter with two guys working for me, and we're going off, go rescue people and doing whatever. That's awesome. Who wants to do anything more than that? I don't want to command anybody. I don't want to tell anyone. I just want to go rescue people and be happy. And, teamwork, very important. The belief, in the gods for them, but the belief in a god for me, was good. Like, I'm superstitious, but I think that the way I feel about things is, and the way they felt about things, like, it's, if you know something to be right, and you just feel it, and it feels right, then it's the truth, and that's what life's about finding those truths that'll, unlock doors and potentials and lead you to places in your life. Dude, I was made to be right here, right now, doing this job. And the teaching aspect of Dionysus is mind-blowing to me, because he was a student of life. I consider myself a student of life. And it's important to pass on things so maybe people after you have a little bit easier time, because life's not easy when you're stupid. You gotta be strong. I think, like the Jackass song goes. Life is good. If you get a chance, read Gates of Fire. It will change your life. It's changed my life. It's touched me. It moved me. It was amazing. I don't think doesn't get any better than Gates of Fire and Stephen Pressfield. He also wrote Baggar Vance. Awesome book. If you read everything from Stephen Pressfield, he's the war of art. The man's a genius. He writes very well. He speaks very well, very eloquently. And Gates of Fire, it'll change your life, much like surfing and a bunch of other things, but it will definitely touch you. It should. If it doesn't touch you, then you're not a warrior, and that's okay. You know, some people are born loving ballet or opera, and some people you have to learn in appreciation. I learned that from Richard Gere in Pretty Woman. But anyway, so Reed Gates of Fire, big hooyah to Ivan Ruiz, and good night from Hollow Lotus.